नमस्कार फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज लिविंग इकोनॉमिक्स एंड आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट टू मेजर ब्रांचेस ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स इन दिस वीडियो. वन इज माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स एंड द अदर इज मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स. आई विल बी टेकिंग अप टू थिंग्स इन दिस. वन डेफिनेटली इज व्हाट इज माइक्रो एंड मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स एंड सेकेंड इज व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन माइक्रो एंड मैक्रो. What I'm going to do is, I'll be taking a few news articles to suggest you, to tell you what exactly is the difference between microeconomics and macroeconomics. The idea of taking up news articles is also, helpful in understanding that this economics is definitely not the alien subject. It is not away from our life. It is our life. We are living it daily, whether you want it or not. And this is the idea behind not taking up the bookish examples, but taking up the real news from the newspaper, from today's newspaper, because this is living economics, so we have to understand these concepts through this way. So microeconomics studies about the individual unit of the economy. Individual unit can be a single consumer, it can be a household, it can be a single producer, it can be a firm, it can be the decision making of the individual with whatever budget they have and whatever wants they have. In the same manner, it also discusses and analyzes about a firm, its profit maximization goal, how it achieves its profit maximization, what should be the output level. It also studies about the prices of the factors of production. Already land, labor and capital. What should be the price of land? What is the price of labor, capital and all these things? So micro studies about a single unit, whether it is about its price, demand and supply and so on. On the other hand, macroeconomics studies the entire economy as a whole. So it studies the aggregate. In this, we discuss about unemployment, we discuss about inflation rate, we discuss about the national income, real GDP, nominal GDP. We discuss about different government policies, economic policies, fiscal policy and monetary policy. So what we are going to do now is we are going to check the newspaper and find out which is microeconomics news and which is macroeconomics news, so that we are able to understand the difference between microeconomics and macroeconomics clearly. So here you go. Okay, so you can see that the first news is all about petrol hits record 84.5 rupees per liter in Delhi, whereas diesel at rupees 74.63 per liter. This you can see is a microeconomics news because it is talking about a single unit or a good, which is petrol, and the prices of petrol and diesel in Delhi. Now let us check the second news, which is all about how Dixon Technologies, which is the second largest electronics maker, has bagged a contract to manufacture phones and smart TVs for Nokia. This news belongs to microeconomics because it is all about two firms. One is Dixon Technology and the other is Nokia, and their decision making process of maximizing profit might be one of the reasons, or maybe the goal of maximizing revenue, or maybe minimizing costs. Now let us have a look at the third news, which talks about prices of mutton, fish rise 15 to 20% as consumers dump chicken. You see, it is all about microeconomics. Demand for chicken has come down because of the outbreak of bird flu, and demand for mutton and fish has gone up. Because of that, the price of mutton and fish has gone up by 15 to 20%. So this is all about individual goods, about mutton, about fish, about chicken, its demand, its supply, its price. It belongs to microeconomics news. Okay, now let's go and check the news on macroeconomics. So first is India to clock 9% growth in financial year 2020. It is a report by Bank of America Securities, which says that because of the increase in consumption of the economy, which is the aggregate consumption, India becomes the fastest growing economies, which has a growth rate of 9%, which talks about real GDP growth rate of 9%. So this definitely is clear, is a macroeconomics news which talks about the aggregate consumption, and because of that, the national income of the economy is growing. Let's look at the second news, which talks about the monetary policy of RBI, which is a central bank of the country, Central Bank of India, and also talks about inflation rate, which is the general price level. So you can see it talks about no room for RBI to cut rates despite sharp fall in inflation. So you see, it is talking about the inflation, the general price level, which is the aggregate price level of the entire economy, and not the prices of fish or mutton or smartphones.
At the same time, it talks about the monetary policy of the economy, which is conducted by the Reserve Bank of India, which is the central bank. And this monetary policy affects the entire economy and not only one or two firms. So this category also belongs to the macroeconomics.
So did you find out that in macroeconomics, we were talking about inflation compared to microeconomics when we were talking about the prices of petrol, prices of diesel, you know, the prices of fish, mutton, the company's decision to take up smartphones. On the other hand, in macroeconomics, we were talking about the growth of the economy, the monetary policy of RBI, the Central Bank of India. When you're talking about price of a particular good, you know, fish, mutton, you're talking about a price of a single unit. I mean, a unit, individual unit, whether it is any unit. On the other hand, when you're talking about inflation or general price level, you're talking about the prices of all the goods and services which are there in the consumer price index. In the same manner, we're talking about a firm, how it grows. You're talking about a single firm and you talk about its growth. Whereas when you're talking about macroeconomics, you study the growth of the economy, and this growth of the economy takes into account the growth of the entire firm, individual producers and everyone. Right. So micro takes up the approach from, you know, bottom to top, whereas macro takes up the approach from top to bottom. Okay. Also, few of us gets confused with micro and macro. So even though we know what is the difference between the price of a firm and the general price level, but still we forget which news belongs to microeconomics and which news belongs to macroeconomics. Let me tell you, there we can differentiate between micro and macro with the spelling of what microeconomics and macroeconomics. So there is one difference between micro and macro, which is I in micro, M-I-C-R-O, and A in macro, which is M-A-C-R-O. I denotes to individual. So if you see micro with I, you understand this is the microeconomic analysis of individual units. And when it is about macro A, it talks about aggregate or all, right? So with aggregate or all, you understand we're talking about all goods and services as a whole compared to I, which is individual. So hope you have understood this concept clearly with the help of the news. That's it for now. Stay tuned for more. Till then, take care. Bye.